Welcome to this tutorial on electronically submitting a change of PDPI request for a grant through ERA Commons Prior Approval Module. As you know, a PDPI of an award can be changed any time during the lifetime of the award. Previously, to change a PDPI on an award, the signing official, SO, of the grant had to send an email to the program official and the grants management specialist requesting them to change the PDPI on an award. This process can now be accomplished electronically through the Prior Approval Module. Benefit of providing this functionality electronically is that it can now be done through ERA Commons, an environment familiar to SOs, and it allows the tracking of submitted requests. A change of PDPI request can only be initiated and submitted by an SO. Requests can only be initiated on a grant year that is currently awarded and only within the current budget period. Accessing the functionality starts with logging into ERA Commons. Once logged in, SOs need to navigate to the Prior Approval tab on the top navigation menu. The SO will see an option to initiate a request in the box to the left. The SO will have a box for existing prior approval requests, under which the List My Requests and Search for Requests will be available. List My Requests will display any requests that were initiated and are waiting for them for further processing or approving the request and sending it to NIH. SOs can search for any prior approval request through the Search for Request page. If the request has not been submitted to NIH, users can modify and submit the request, and if the request has already been submitted to NIH, they can view the history of the request type and also view the request PDF submitted to NIH. To initiate a change of PDPI request, the SOs will go to the Initiate a Prior Approval Request box. In the field for request type, they will select Change of PDPI Request. Click Go. The system will generate a list of eligible applications for change of PDPI. The results are displayed in a table showing the grant number, project title, contact PDPI name, and budget period end date. Because SOs manage all the applications and grants, they have two text filter fields they can use at the top of the screen to narrow the results to the application they want. Once the application is found, click on the radio button to the far left to select the application. Once that is done, the Initiate Change of PDPI Request button becomes active. Click the button to start the request. This will open the Prior Approval Request Change of PDPI form. It will display the applicant's information like PDPI User ID, Name of PDPI, Grants Management Specialist Details, Program Official Details, the Grant Number, Application Title, Institution Name, Budget Period, and Project Period. In the Request Details section, it will display the Request ID, a system-generated ID number, PDPI name, and user ID assigned to the current grant year. A section to enter a new PDPI name, which is a type ahead field. Based on the name entered, the system will calculate the PI ID. The SO will also have to enter if the newly added PDPI will be a contact PI or not, and also inform the level of effort in person months for either calendar or academic or summer. The biosketch and other support documents for the newly added PDPI are all required while submitting the request, though it is not required for an existing PI unless there is a change in any of these documents of level of effort. Once all of this information is provided, the SO will have to select the Add New button to add the PI to the application or to replace the existing single PI application. The SO will provide the effective date from when the newly added PIs will start their work. For applications where human subject education is required, the human subject's education is up to date for the PIs on this request checkbox should be checked, without which they cannot submit the request to NIH. If the application is a multi-PI application, the SO should also provide the leadership plan document, PDF only, along with all the documents, PDF only, that are requested on the screen. You can upload only one PDF document for each document section, each not to exceed 5 megabytes in size. To upload a file, click the Upload button, navigate to the desired document, and select the document. When the upload is complete, you will see a green box appear above the upload button to indicate a successful upload. The name of the file will be displayed below, along with the date it was uploaded. You can view the file by clicking the View button, or remove the file by clicking the Delete button. There is still more work to be done before submitting to the agency. The request can be saved as is by clicking the Save button. You will see a green confirmation message at the top of the screen when the save is complete. Hitting the Cancel button will bring you back to the prior approval screen after confirming that you agreed to lose any unsaved data. The SO can now submit the request to NIH by clicking the Submit button, which changes the status of the request to submitted to agency. Once the request has been submitted, a PDF document is generated based on the request submitted. This PDF document can be viewed in Search for Requests tab. A notification is sent to the SO, GMO, and PO of the application when the change of PDPI request is submitted to NIH. This concludes this tutorial on electronically submitting a change of PDPI request for an application through ERA Commons. A number of resources are available to you should you need assistance with this process. Screen help is available by clicking on the question mark on the prior approval screens. If you still have questions about submitting change of PDPI requests electronically, contact the ERA Service Desk. Thanks for watching.